Good morning, everybody. This is Sunday, the 19th of April, 2020. And this is Reverend Akai from House of Refuge. And today, I just want to give you a quick word of encouragement just to keep you going. I want to thank God because this lockdown is teaching us to stand, is teaching us to build our lives in Christ, is teaching us to depend on God. And I want to thank God because he has kept us through this season and he's been faithful. And today I just want to give you one word within a few minutes and I'll be gone so that you can chew on it and build something on it. 3 John, I'll read from the book of 3 John, verse 3 to 5. 3 John, verse 3 to 5. The Bible says, "For I was greatly pleased when some of the brothers came from time to time and testified to your faithfulness to the truth. That is how you are living and walking in truth. Verse 4, I have no greater joy than this, to hear that my spiritual children are living their lives in the truth. Beloved, you are acting faithfully in what you are providing for the brothers, and especially when they are strangers." I see Apostle John here commending the church for walking in the spirit of the truth of the gospel. What is the truth of the gospel? The gospel, when it's received, it produces fruit. And one of the fruit, one of the manifestation of the truth of the gospel is seen in the spirit of generosity. And he said, you are walking in the truth in that you have been assisting the brethren. And so if there is a time that the truth of the gospel needs to express itself, find expression in us believers, it is in this season of lockdown where a lot of people have lost their jobs, particularly those who depend on a daily livelihood and can't work anymore. There are things that are happening that have crippled a lot of people, and a lot of people are desperate. If there is any time that a spirit of generosity is needed in the world all over, it is this season, a spirit of generosity. And I want to encourage brethren that this is the time to look around you and manifest this fruit of the spirit of generosity, which is the spirit of the gospel. I remember when John the Baptist came, he heralded the coming of Jesus Christ. And he began to preach repentance to the people, say, repent and prepare yourself for the kingdom that is about to come. A kingdom that will be ushered by one who is greater than I am. And the people gathered and were curious and asked John, say, what is this kingdom all about? Can you give us a glimpse into what you are teaching? And John said something that took my attention in the book of Luke. He said something in the book of Luke, chapter 3, verse 11. He said, and John replied, the man who has two tunics is to share with he who has none, and he who has food is to do the same. John the Baptist went straight to the spirit of generosity, because that is the spirit of the gospel. The Bible says, for God so loved the world that he gave. And Jesus said something in John chapter 13, verse 34. He said, greater love had no man than this, that a man lay down his life for his friends. So sacrificial giving and generosity is part of the root of Christianity. I urge you now to look around and see somebody that needs your help. Look around, see somebody that needs a hand. Extend a helping hand to somebody. For this is the spirit of the season. And this is what God is expecting of us. One of the evidence of the spirit of truth is what? Generosity. Generosity. And you are not generous because you have a lot. The little you have, you can share. The little you have, you can look around and see somebody who needs more than you do and help them. Let's hold each other's hands. And as you do that, share the love of Christ. Give them something. Tell them God loves you. Give them something. Tell them Jesus is coming very soon. We know that he is coming. The signs are there and we're expecting the coming of the Savior. And the Bible says, comfort one another with these words that he is coming soon. We will comfort each other. We will remain expectant. and joyful, but will continue to occupy until the hour comes, because we were not meant to relax and wait for him to come. We are meant to be found working. Our lamps are meant to be found, you know, burning bright. So keep working, keep moving, and let the spirit of generosity have its roots in you. May the Lord bless you and continue steadfast in the love of Christ. Thank you.